video, I'm going to discuss all those partial differential equations which can be solved using Lagrange's method. And in Lagrange's method also, we are going to use the multipliers. The multipliers in such a way that the denominator comes out to be zero. So when the denominator comes out to be zero, we integrate the numerator to get the answer. So I have collected few of the questions which has this. All the questions here in this slide can be solved using this method. That is, we may choose the multipliers in such a way that it makes the denominator zero and the numerator can be directly integrated. So these are few questions, and all the questions can be solved using this method, or you may say trick. So in this video, I'm going to discuss Lagrange's method. Suppose I have this auxiliary equation. So in this auxiliary equation, all the questions will be solved by the method that if we take L, M and N as the multipliers, if we take these multipliers, it will reduce to L dx plus M dy plus N dz upon say L p plus M q plus N z. So we choose L, M, N in such a way that it makes this denominator zero. So when this denominator comes out to be zero, this whole, when you equate this, any one of this, say dx upon p or maybe dy upon q or say dz upon r, we get L dx plus M dy plus N dz is equal to zero. Now we integrate this to get the answer. So the answer will be Lx plus My plus Nz is equal to zero. So this will be the answer. So all the question in this slide will be solved by this method only. So let us take up first question. So first, that is question number 2 of the slide, which is say z x plus y p, this small p, plus z x minus y, say small q, is equal to x square plus y square. Now Lagrange's auxiliary equation is auxiliary equation in this case is given by dx upon z x plus y, dy upon z x minus y, and dz upon x square plus y square. Now we choose the multipliers as x minus y and minus z. So these are the multipliers which we are choosing. So after choosing these multipliers, we get x dx minus y dy minus z dz upon say xz x plus y minus yz x minus y minus z x square plus y square. So this will come out to be x dx minus y dy minus z dz is equal upon 0. So our choice of multiplier, this choice of multipliers was like that, it made the denominator 0. So once the denominator is 0, we may equate it with any of these, say dx upon p, or you may say dx upon z x plus y. So our answer will be x dx minus y dy minus z dz is equal to 0. So on integrating we get x square minus y square minus z square is equal to c, say c1, an arbitrary constant. So c1 is an arbitrary constant. Now again we choose our multiplier as y, x and minus z. So this time choice of multiplier is y, x and minus z. So this will make our equation as y dx. So these are our multipliers which we chose. So this will make y dx plus x dy minus z dz upon y z x plus y plus x z x minus y minus z x square plus y square. Again, when you solve this, you will see that the denominator comes again to be 0. So when this whole denominator on solving comes out to be 0, if this is equal to 0, we are left with y dx plus x dy minus z dz is equal to 0. So on integrating, what do we get? On integrating, we get y dx plus x dy minus z dz. So we have to integrate this and we have this. So on integration we get, it is, this one is 2dxy minus 2zdz, if we do this, is equal to 0. Answer will be 2xy minus z square is equal to, say, some constant c2. Now we got both the equation and we write the solution, 5x square minus y square minus z square upon 2xy minus z, 2xy minus z square is equal to 0, where this is the answer, where this phi, this are phi is the arbitrary function. So in our question number 2 also, this question number 2, y minus zx p plus x plus yz q is equal to x square plus y square. In this case also, we'll take the multipliers. We take the multipliers as x minus yz, we'll get the denominator 0. We get the denominator 0. Again, we take the multipliers as yx minus 1. And again, we get the denominator 0 and we'll get the two answers for this. So, this is something which you should try yourself. And now, this is next question. In this case, the multipliers are x minus y and z, and second multipliers are y, x minus 1. In question number 3, let us check this question. So in this case, the auxiliary equation, Lagrange's auxiliary equation is dx upon x plus 2z dy upon 4zx minus y, and which is equal to dz upon 2x square y. So, the trick which we are discussing here is to make the denominator 0 by taking the multipliers in such a way. So, we have to take the multipliers in such a way that the denominator is 0. So, first multipliers which we choose is, choose the multipliers as y, x and minus 2z. So, once we choose the multipliers as this, we get y dx plus x dy minus 2z dz upon y x plus 2z plus x 4z x minus y minus 2z 2x square plus y. Now let us solve this. So on solving this, we'll get y dx plus x dy minus 2z dz. So our trick which I am discussing today is to make this denominator 0 by taking the multiplier in such a way. So we have took the multiplier in such a way that the denominator comes out to be 0. So this particular denominator, this thing comes out to be 0. So we have this upon 0. So what do we get? So we get d of xy. So this is y dx plus x dy is d of xy minus 2z dz is equal to 0. So first we get xy minus z square is equal to the first constant, say c1. So this is the first one. Now we choose another multiplier, and another multiplier which we choose will be, so choose another multiplier as 2x minus 1 minus 1. So our equation will be 2x dx minus dy minus dz upon 2x x plus 2z minus 4z x minus y minus 2x square plus y. So as per the multiplier we got this, and on solving the denominator, let us solve this whole denominator. On solving the denominator, it comes out to be 0. So once the denominator comes out to be 0, we get 2x dx minus dy minus dz is equal to 0. So we'll get x square minus y minus z is equal to some other constant, say c2. So what we have seen in all the cases, we are taking the multipliers in such a way that this denominator comes out to be 0. So our final answer in this case will be 5xy minus z square comma x square minus y minus z is equal to 0. So I discussed so many questions in the slide. You have to solve all the questions and let me know in the chat box which questions you are unable to solve. In all the question, you have to make the denominator, this denominator term 0. That is, in all the question, what we have to follow is, we have to take this LMN, the multipliers. We have to choose the multipliers in such a way that the denominator comes out to be 0.